got a roller, use your roller. If you haven't got a roller, that's fine. Just lie on your back, flat on the floor, with a pillow underneath your head so that your neck, your chin isn't sticking up in the air. Your neck needs to be lengthened. Okay? So we're just going to start with our usual little warm-up. Nothing too complicated, just to get everything moving. Okay, so let's just practice breathing first. So when you're ready, get comfortable, take a big deep breath. Expand your rib cage and then squeeze your tummy muscles and pull the bottom of your rib cage down towards your belly button to engage the core. Okay, hold that there and keep breathing. So when we do the exercises, this is how you need to hold the abdominals. Okay, so never holding your breath, always breathing, pressing the back of your rib cage down towards the floor. Okay. Okay, let's relax. And then we're going to add in the pelvic tilts now. So if you take a deep breath in again, tense the tummy muscles, engage the core, pull the ribs down, and then as you breathe out, tilt your pelvis so you're pressing the small of your back into the floor, and breathe in to release. And again, breathe out, tilt, and breathe in, release. So try and make sure you've got your shoulders relaxed. Try not to tense anything up. So you just want to concentrate on your breathing and on engaging the core. So let's try squeezing the pelvic floor muscles as well now. So imagine you're going to the loo and you're just stopping your wee mid-flow. So breathing out, pressing the back into the floor, and breathing in, release. Let's do four more of those. Breathe out, tilt, and breathe in, release. Last three. Try and breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth, if that feels comfortable. And relax. Okay, one knee at a time into the chest. Now breathe in, tighten, tummy in, ribs down. And then as you breathe out, bring your right knee towards your chest and lower your foot back down as you breathe in. Change sides, so we're just alternating. You've always got one foot on the floor. One movement before you do the other leg. So keeping the shoulders relaxed, keep breathing. Just mobilizing the hips before we start. Last two. Okay, put your feet and your knees together now. Take a deep breath in. Tense the tummy, engage the core, and then I want you to just slowly drop your right knee out to the right and back to the centre. Change legs, left knee out to the left. So we're just doing one leg at a time. I don't do both legs together, it's a bit like having a smear if you do that. Not very nice. Last four. So again, we're just mobilising the hips. Two. And one more. And relax. Okay, take your feet apart again a little bit. Take a breath. Tense the tummy, engage the core. And then as you breathe out, now we're going to slide the right leg straight, flex the foot, and then bring it back to the start position. Change legs. Slide the left leg. So remember, you're doing the movements slowly to your breath. Breathing out on the extension and breathing in as you bend the knee again. So remember to keep your core engaged the whole time, pressing the back of your ribs towards the floor. Okay, on the next one, we're going to add in the opposite arm. So if you're straightening your right leg, you're lifting your left arm above your head. So as far as you can comfortably, and then change sides. So left leg, right arm, and lower down. So we're starting to mobilise the shoulders now as well. Okay, and then when you're ready, we're going to lift both arms at the same time. But you're only lifting one leg. Sliding one leg. Don't slide both legs. If you're on your roller, it does make you wobble. So try and keep your heel in contact with the mat to stop you from falling off your roller. Okay, last time. And then if you hold your arms above your chest now, we're going to open them out to the side and bring them back above the chest. So you want to squeeze your shoulder blades into the floor or into the roller. Excuse me. So still breathing, get used to the rhythm with the breath. Once you get the hang of it, you'll just do it without thinking then. Okay, last time. And let's do some circles now. So just small circles, and you're going to circle both hands outwards. Again, pressing your shoulder blades into the floor or the muscle into the roller if you're using a roller. Okay, change direction now. Circle both hands inwards. Just small circles. Taking both arms all the way over your head, bring them round and do some nice big circles now. Remember, you can bend your elbows if your shoulders are painful, just to make it a little bit easier. So try and get full range of movement. Just move that plant up a little. Bring the arms down to the side and round over the head. Okay, last time, and then holding the arms above the chest, palms of the hands facing together, we're going to lift up the right shoulder off the roller or the floor. And turn the head to the left. So you're reaching your fingertips towards the ceiling, turning your head away from the arm that you're lifting, reaching as high as you can. Stiff neck today. I slept funny last night. Hopefully this will help. Last one. And relax. Okay, we're going to pop both hands behind the head now. So you're resting the weight of your head in your hands, and then we're going to curl the top of the spine off the roller or the floor. Take a breath. Tense the tummy, engage the core, and then tucking your chin under, give yourself a double chin and curl. Top of the spine, one vertebra at a time, and then curl back down. So you're going to try and get that nice movement in the vertebra, moving each one individually. So you shouldn't be pulling on your neck. Your hands are just like a shelf, just resting the weight of your head. To breathe, breathing out as you lift. Last one. And relax the head back down. Okay, we're going to do bridging now. Get your head comfortable, going to keep your head on the pillow, hands on the floor, palms down, and then bring your feet and your knees together, and we're going to curl the hips and the bottom off the floor now. Breathe in, tense the tummy, engage the core, and then slowly lifting your bottom and your hips. Again, curling one vertebra at a time, so you're not coming up in a straight line. And then if you can, try and squeeze your knees together as you lift. Imagine you're squeezing something between your knees. floor now. We're going to slide the right leg straight, flex the foot, and then we're going to lift the right leg up and down. So take a breath, tense your tummy, engage the core, and then slowly lift that right leg. Now, don't need to bend your leg, keep it completely straight so that when you lift it, you can feel a stretch in your calf and your hamstrings. It's all the way down the back of your leg. If you start to get cramp, then just relax your foot. And try and go further and further each time, just increasing the stretch. Breathe out, lift. Breathe in, lower. Keep the core engaged. Last one. And rest. Okay, just swap legs now. Left leg, extend, flex the foot, take a breath. Engage and breathing out, lifting and breathing in, slowly control the leg back down. So try not to go too quickly. Everything should be controlled. Slow, concentrate on what you're doing. Try pushing a little bit further each time, feeling that stretch down the backs of your legs. Last two. Okay, we're going to come off the roller now, so just slide off, drop it to one side, and then put your head back on your pillow, hands down, feet and knees together, and then we're going to go side to side now. Breathe in, tighten, tummy in, ribs down, and then when you breathe out, take your knees to the right, both knees at the same time, back to the centre, keeping the core engaged, and then to the left. Exhale on the way down, inhale on the way back up. Okay, let's add in the arms now, arms above the chest, and take the arms in the opposite direction. You can turn your head as well if you want to. If it makes you feel a little bit queasy, then just keep your head facing the ceiling. Your chest now, just gently pull them in and then have a little rock from side to side. So we're going to start today with the calves on the table. So imagine that you're just resting your calves on the table that's in front of you. 90 degree bend in the knee and also in the hip if you can manage that as well. Okay, hands are down. Point your toes, so you're going to pretend there's a puddle at the bottom of your mat and you're going to dip your toes in the puddle. Okay, so breathe in, tense the tummy, engage the core, and then as you breathe out, gently take that leg down, dip your toe in the puddle, bring it back up and change sides. So you're going to have both of your legs moving at the same time. Okay, they're crossing over each other in the middle. One's going up, one's going down. So try and maintain that core engagement. So you've got to keep your back flat to the floor. Can't reach the puddle, it doesn't matter, just go halfway down if you need to, if your hips feel uncomfortable or if you can't maintain the core engagement. Okay, now I want you to try, if you can, this is optional, to lift your head and shoulders and stretch both arms forward. Okay, so you're still doing the same thing with the legs. Okay, then we're going to add in an arm, we're going to take the opposite arm over the head. You've still got your head lifted, chin tucked under, and then you're stretching the arms over the head, still dipping your toes in the puddle. So remember your breathing. Last four. Bring your knees in, put your head back onto your pillow, and just give your legs a little rock from side to side. Okay, we're going to take both legs straight up in the air now if you can. So you're trying to keep your legs straight if possible. And then we're going to draw a figure of eight, but the number eight is on its side, like an infinity sign. Okay, so breathe in, tense the tummy, engage the core, and then circle around one way, cross over, and then circle the other way. So start with small circles, and then you can make them bigger if you want to, if it feels comfortable. So again, you're maintaining that core engagement. Still breathing, don't hold your breath. Last four, last three, last two. If you can, remember you can stop. If you start to lose control, just rest. Last one. Bring your knees in again, give them a hug, and then again just gently rock from side to side. Okay, pop your hands back on the floor, take your legs straight back up in the air again. So we're going to pretend we're cycling now, but really slowly, okay, going up a big hill. So take a breath, tense, engage, and then start to circle the legs. So if you start with small circles, maintain the core engagement, and then when you're ready, I want you to do bigger ones. So we're going really slowly, remember. We're going up a massive hill, you're going up Red Hill. It's not going to be quick, is it? Unless you've got one of those electric bikes. So just make sure that the small of your back stays pressed towards the floor, okay? Don't let that go. Keep the hands on the floor now, and you're going to use your hands to try and lift your bottom off the floor, okay? So we're going to go up into a kind of a shoulder stand. I know some of you can't do this very well sometimes, so just do what you can, okay? So use your hands, tuck your chin under, take a deep breath in, tense the tummy, and then you're going to lift your feet, and then using your hands, curl yourself off the floor, point the toes, and then control back down, and put your feet back on the floor. And again, curl up, push up as high as you can. So you might not get very high. If your back isn't flexible, that's okay. You can work on it. Push up. When you curl down, make sure that you curl one vertebra at a time. It needs to be controlled. Don't drop it down too quickly. Remember, you can use your hands for a little bit of assistance. Well done, last two. And one more. And relax, bring the knees in. Cross is next. So for this one, just slide your pillow to one side. So we're going to put both hands behind the head again, resting the weight of the head in the hands, into tabletop, okay? I think we'll flex the feet for this one, so toes up, and then we're going to take the right shoulder to the left knee and the left shoulder to the right knee, okay? So take a breath, tense the tummy, engage the core, and then lift your right shoulder towards your left knee and change sides. So try not to go too fast. And then to increase the level, you're going to extend the other leg away. So one knee's coming into the chest, and the other leg is pushing and straightening, as if you're pushing something away from you. So please don't pull on your neck, just resting the weight of the head in the hands, tucking the chin under and breathing. So the lower you take that extended leg, the harder you can make it. So remember, the movement is with the breath, don't go too fast. Last four. And relax. This time we're going to stretch both legs straight and try and make your body as long as you can. Take your arms over your head. Just take a couple of deep breaths. And then we're going to pop the pillow back behind our head again. And I want you to make a triangle shape with your hands, so your finger and your thumb are together on each arm, and then put your hands underneath your bottom in that shape. Okay? Pointing the toes now, we're going to lift the right leg first. Breathe in, tense, engage, and then just lift that right leg up and lower it down. Change sides, so think about what you're doing with your middle, concentrating on the core. Control, breathing out to lift the leg, breathing in as you could take it back down. One more time on each leg. And then I want you to have a go at doing both legs at the same time. So big breath, breathe out, lift. Make sure that your lower back feels comfortable. Okay, you might want to just go halfway down if it feels uncomfortable. If you really don't want to do two legs, just do one leg at a time. Carry on with one leg at a time. And done. Breathe out, lift. And you're trying to bring those legs a little bit closer each time, so you're now feeling a stretch in the backs of your legs at the top. Last one. And relax. Okay, get your hands from under your bum and take your arms over your head. Big stretch. And bring the arms down by your side. Okay, we're going to bring both feet off the floor, and I want you to put your knees and your feet together in tabletop. So we're going to do a clam now. So with a clam, you're going to keep your feet together, but you're just going to open your knees, okay? So 90 degree bend in the knee and the hip. Breathe in, tense, engage, and then as you breathe out, open the knees, keeping the feet together, squeeze them open, and then squeeze them back together. And again, breathe out, squeeze open, and close. Now once you've got the hang of that, make sure that you've still got your core engagement and you're still breathing. Last four. Concentrate, relax the shoulders. And one more. Okay, relax. And then I want you to cross your ankles, hold on to the fronts of your feet with both hands, and then just pull your feet towards your body. Okay, so you're in a curled up little ball. So just pull the knees. Or pull the feet rather. Just a little stretch as well. And relax. Okay, we're going to roll over now onto our side. So get your neck and your head comfortable. You can either stretch your arm out and put your pillow on your arm like that, or just get rid of your pillow and rest your head in your hand. So I want you to bend your bottom leg and keep your top leg straight, and we're going to flex the top foot. Okay, so toes up, hand in front, take a breath, tense the tummy, engage the core, and then lift the leg up. And then as you come down, we're going to point the toes. So you're changing the angle of your foot. So flexing the foot, lift, pointing the toes, lower. So make sure that your hip bone is pointing straight ahead. If it's pointing towards the ceiling, then you haven't got your hips in the right position, okay? Squeezing the muscles down the legs. Breathing. Three more. That's two. And one more. Okay, hold it there. We're going to flex the foot now, and we're going to do a side kick. So breathe in, tense the tummy, engage the core, keep your legs straight, kick forward and backwards. So you want to try and get as much range of movement in the hip as you can, keeping the legs straight so you're feeling a stretch down the backs of your legs and at the front of your hip when you go backwards. Now try and take the arm away from the floor so that you have to use your abdominals a little bit more to stop you from falling over. Two. Okay, and then pointing your toes now, we're going to circle. Breathe in, tighten, tummy and ribs down, and start circling backwards. So control. So you should be starting to feel the burn now. Too much for you, just have a little rest. You can join in again when you're ready. Okay, let's go the other way now, circling forwards. Stretch now. Hold on to your ankle or your foot. Pull your foot towards your bottom and then push your hip forward so you can feel a stretch down the front of your thigh. So that should get rid of the little pain in your hip as well. Okay, now I want you to pull your leg back so you're feeling the stretch a little bit higher up. It should be a bit more intense now. If you want to, you can press your foot against your hand to make it a little bit more intense again. It's a good stretch, this one, if you sit down a lot. You've got a sitting down job. And relax. Okay, let's point the toes now. Imagine you're a ballerina and you're standing up on your tiptoes. Okay, pop your hand back on the floor. Take a deep breath in, tense, engage, and then we're going to lift the top leg, but not too high, okay? And then lift your bottom leg up as well, and then lower both legs down. Excuse me, top leg, bottom leg, and lower both legs down. And again, top, bottom, slowly relax down. Five to go. Last three. You can manage, rest if you need to. Last two. And one more. And relax. Okay, we're going to just roll over onto our front now. together. Okay, and rest your forehead on your hands now. And then when you're ready, take a breath. Tense the tummy, and then just lift your head and your chest as high as you can. Lower it back down. And again, breathe out, lift. Focusing now on the muscles in your lower back, try and relax your bottom so when you lift, you don't tense the muscles in your bottom, okay? Just keep it relaxed. Last two. When you lift, you squeeze any tummy muscles in just to protect your spine. One more time. And relax. So keeping your forehead on your hands, you're going to lift both legs now. So breathe in, tighten, tummy in, ribs down, and then lift both legs up, open the feet, close the feet, and relax both feet back down to the floor. Again, lift the legs, open the feet, close the feet, lower the feet down. And again, lift, open, close, and lower. So you're trying to keep your legs as straight as you can, okay? We're not bending them. Keeping them straight, pointing the toes, squeezing the muscles down the fronts of your thighs. Four more if you can. Try not to hold your breath. Keep the breathing going. Last two. One more time. Okay, just turn your head to the side, have a little bit of a rest. Turn it towards the screen so you can see. So the next one, we're going to do swimming. So don't do anything yet, you're just resting. You're going to take both arms above your head, looking straight down at your mat. You're going to lift both arms, both legs, keep everything straight, and then we're going to paddle as if we're swimming on the bottom of the sea. Okay? So when you're ready, extend both arms above your head. So remember to keep your head down, you're looking at the fish on the bottom of the sea. Take a deep breath, tense the tummy, engage the core, lift the arms and the legs as high as you can, keep them straight, and then off you go. So I know we're in the water, but you are breathing. You've got an oxygen tank on. Keep it going if you can, rest if you need to. Eight more, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Bring your arms back, turn your head to the side, and rest. Okay, I want you to push up now. Come onto your hands and knees. So in a nice square shape with your toes flat on the floor, okay? Don't curl your toes under. So take your hands a little bit wider now so that they're on the edge of your mat. If you've got a really wide mat, you can keep your hands on your mat. But if your mat's quite thin like mine, put your hands on the outside of your mat. So breathe in. Tense the tummy, and then I want you to lower your nose towards the floor and take your elbows out to the side. Push back up, and again, lower the nose, and push back up. Two more. So we're going to call this a level one push up, and rest. Okay, we're going to move to level two now, so I want you to take your hands forward and flatten out your bottom. So you're pushing your hips forward. Sorry about this, Jean. So your bum is now nice and flat, okay? You're on an angle. Let's try that again. Breathe in, tighten. Breathe out. Lower your chest to the floor and push up. Okay, keep going. Now, if you're finding that too hard and you can't do it, I want you to go back onto your hands and knees again and just lower the nose to the floor. Let's do four more. Three, last two, go into a prayer stretch. Sit your bottom on your heels and then lengthen the arms. Take the arms as far forward as you can. You're trying to keep your arms straight. Relax your head down and press both hands gently into the floor. Okay, come back up onto your hands and knees. Then I want you to turn round 180 degrees so that your head is on the opposite end of your mat. And then lying on our side again, so we're going to do the other leg. You thought I'd forgotten, didn't you? So lying on your side, so you can use your pillow on your arm or you can put your head in your hand. Okay, so get your hips in the right position. Your hip bone is pointing forward, okay, not towards the ceiling. So bending your bottom leg, your top leg is straight, and we're going to start with the foot flexed. Hand in front, take a breath, tense, engage, and then lift that leg up, and then pointing the toe, lower it down. So flex the foot, lift it up, point the toe, control it back down. And then again, flex, lift up, point, lower down. Keep it going. Remembering to keep the core engaged and you're still breathing, don't hold your breath. Last four, flex to lift, point to lower. Last two. Down and then kicking forward and backwards. So you're trying to get as much range of movement in the hip as you can, keeping the leg straight so you're feeling a stretch in the back of the leg as you kick forward and in the hip at the front as you kick back. Last three. Pointing the toes now, breathe in, tighten, and we're going to circle backwards. So control, don't go too fast. Circling backwards. Well done. I'm just sitting up a bit so I can see you a bit better. You don't have to sit up. Okay, let's change direction. So you're stretching now, hold on to your ankle or your foot and then just push your hip forward, so you're tilting your hip forward so you can feel a stretch down the front of your thigh. Okay, just hold that there. My microphone's making a funny noise, you just stay there, carry on. So you're feeling it in the hip flexors. This is the sitting down stretch, if you sit down a lot. So pull that leg back, and then if you want to make it more intense, press your foot against your hand. Can you do a thumbs up if you can still hear me? You're all okay. So I just had to turn the mic down a little bit. You probably couldn't hear it, but it was making a horrible humming noise. Okay, relax. And then into your standing on tiptoes like a ballerina. Pointing the toes. Breathe in, tighten. Tummy and ribs down. And then lift your top leg. Lift your bottom leg. And lower both legs down. again, lift the top leg, bottom leg, and relax back down. Six more of these if you can, keeping that core engaged. Keep breathing. Last four. Last three. And one more time. And rest. Well done. Okay, roll over now onto your tummy again. So we're going to put both hands underneath the shoulders now, okay? So the further back you have them, the higher you're going to be able to lift. So please be careful if you've got problems with your lower back. Just do it gently to begin with. So head looking straight down, breathe in, tighten. And then as you breathe out, tense your tummy and come up into a cobra. And curl back down. So imagine you're on a piece of sellotape and you're peeling yourself off the floor. Slowly back down. So this is mobilizing the spine and working your triceps, otherwise known as bingo wings. I dread to think what mine would be like if I didn't do exercise. My whole family's got big arms. You can tell when I put weight on, I start to look like a big fat blobby armed person. Last three if you can, so you should be feeling it now. That funny song's on again, isn't it? Makes me laugh, this song. Last one. And come up onto all fours. So you're on your hands and knees, and we're going to come into a cat stretch now. Angry cat, drop your head, round your back, push your hips forward. So we've all had practice with the press-ups. Jean's not going to be speaking to me now. We're going to do them again, okay? So get your hands wide if you want to. Stay on all fours or come onto your hips down position, okay? So your bottom is down. So we're going to do four and then we're going to stand up, okay? So breathe and tighten, tummy in, ribs down, and then lower your chest or your nose to the floor. Push up, three more. Last two. One more time. Okay, and then pop your feet on the floor, lift your knees so you're in a full press-up position, breathe in, tighten, and then as you breathe out, we're going to walk the hands towards the feet, and I want you to try not to bend your knees if you can. Okay, and then you're folded in half, breathe in again, and then as you breathe out, we need to uncurl your spine, one vertebra at a time, until you're standing up straight, and then roll your shoulders back and down. So pull your shoulder blades down your back. Okay, let's go again. Reversing that now, breathe in. Tense the tummy, drop your chin to your chest. So darting from your neck now, curling yourself down, opening one vertebra at a time. You can do this with your legs apart if you can't reach the floor, okay? Walking your hands with straight legs, if possible. Get into your press-up position. Okay, you can do four press-ups if you want to now, and then do four push-ups with your hands wide or your hands on the mat. It's up to you. One more time. Okay, lift your knees off the floor into a full press-up position. Breathe in, and then walking your hands towards your feet. Take another breath. And then breathing out all the way up, uncurl the spine. And roll your shoulders back, pull your shoulder blades down your spine. Perfect. Reverse, breathe in. Tense, chin to the chest, starting to curl down now. All the way to the floor. Hands on the floor, walk. into your press up position, and then four more press ups. Keep breathing. Last one. Lift the knees. Full press up position. Breathe in. Breathe out. Walk. Breathe in again. Breathe out and curl. Roll the shoulders back and down. Breathe in. Tense, engage. Chin to the chest. Curl. Hands to the floor. Walk. Hold it there. Now I want you to take the bottom in the air into a triangle. Flatten out your bottom now. If you're struggling, drop down to your knees. So you're in a triangle and then into a plank. Into a triangle, into a plank. Four more if you can. Triangle and a plank. Last three. Last two. And one more. Okay, put your knees back on the floor and go into a prayer stretch. Stretch the arms forward, relax your head, gently press the hands into the floor. Okay, come up onto your knees now. Are you all still alive? Being a bit nasty today, aren't I? Sorry, got my Wednesday head on. Arms out now. Relax your shoulders. So try not to scrunch your shoulders. I'm gonna do spine twists. Breathe in, tighten. Tummy and ribs down, and then rotate. Now keep your arms back. Imagine you've got, imagine you're in the stocks. You know those things where people throw tomatoes at you in the street? Keep your arms in that position. Keep the core engaged. Try and keep your neck in line with your spine as well, so you're not turning your head too much. Your head stays where it is, and your body makes you turn. And relax. Okay, into the saw now. I like doing this one because it's a really good hamstring stretch. So get your legs straight. They must be straight. If they're bending, if your knees are bending, then you need to bring your feet closer together. It doesn't matter even if your feet are that closer together. You're still going to feel the stretch, okay? So once you're in your straddle, lift yourself up. Slide yourself forward a bit more, okay? And then again, we're taking the arms out. Relax the shoulders. Breathe in. And then breathe out. Reach to the opposite foot and take the arms out again. So the hand that goes behind, your palm is going to turn towards the ceiling as you reach towards your foot, okay? That's the back hand, not the front hand. So just ease into it gently, don't force it. When you're stretching, it should always feel comfortable, like a nice stretchy feeling, not a snapping feeling. It feels like it's going to snap. You need to ease off a little bit. Once you've got limbered up, you should be able to go a little bit further. Okay, we're going to hold it on this side now, and then either hold on to your leg, your right leg, or put your hands behind. If you're not very flexible, you can try pushing from behind. So you want to get your chest towards your right thigh. Now keep your legs relaxed. If you prefer, you can bend your left leg. You can do whatever you want with your left leg. We're just stretching the right leg. So if you want to move it into a different position, that's okay. So just holding it there. Try and increase the stretch bit by bit, a little bit further. first and back to the arms out. Reach. So you probably find that you can go much further now on your right side. I can go right past my foot now. Holding on to the left leg this time, arms behind or hold the leg. Do whatever you want with your right leg now if you want to change the position. And then slowly just get the chest towards the thigh without forcing it. Increase the stretch as you start to feel more comfortable. Slowly come back up. So let's try that soar again now. Breathe in and breathe out, reach. So you should be able to get further now on that left leg as well. Sitting up tall in between. Last two. And one more. Okay, we're going to stay in this position, so you need to have both legs wide, as wide as you can. And then either put your hands behind, lift yourself up, slide yourself forward. So hands behind or in front. And then we're going to try and drop the chest towards the middle now. Okay? So again, if you're not very flexible, put your hands behind your back and push from behind. Okay? You all right, Mandy? You hurt your back? I can't hear what you're saying, but you look like, tell me after. Just be careful. So keep going a little bit further. You can do a really gentle pulse if you want to, but not too hard. Just gently trying to go further and further down. Chest towards the floor. Try and keep your legs relaxed. Tense them up. It doesn't work as well. You need to keep relaxed, just gently pressing down. Okay, slowly walk back, and then we're going to slide the feet together now and just give your legs a little shake. Going to cross the right foot over the left foot, and then I want you to flex, or rather don't flex, but keep your left foot nice and straight so it's pointing up towards the ceiling. And then pop your hands behind your back, and then we're going to lean forward again so your chest is going towards your thigh again. So this should you should feel this on the side of your leg now. If you don't feel it on the side, that's actually a good thing. It means it's not tight. You might feel it on the back instead. Just pushing gently. And slowly come back up, and we're going to swap over now. So cross your left foot over your right foot. So right foot is straight this time, stretching the right leg. Lean forward, using your hands, gently push forward. And then we're going to put the soles of our feet together, okay? And then slide yourself forward as far as you can comfortably. So you're trying to get your feet as close in as you can. Hold on to your toes, mine are freezing. And then we're going to just pull forward again. If you're not very flexible, put your hands behind your back and push from behind, okay? So you're pulling or pushing and getting the chest again towards the floor. Now, if you can, it's not too painful, get your elbows on your knees and gently press the knees towards the floor. Okay? Don't do it if you've got problems with your hips and it feels really uncomfortable, don't do it. Okay, just be careful. It shouldn't be painful. If it's painful, just ease off. Okay, come back up, and then we're going to cross the legs now. And then put your left hand flat on the floor. Take your right arm above your head. And then using your left hand to lean on, lower yourself down as far as you can. If you're quite flexible, you can come onto your forearm. Put your elbow on the floor. Now, get that right arm as far back as you can, okay? And then pull the shoulder blade down the spine. Before you come up, bring your right arm in front of you, just so you don't hurt yourself getting up, and swap sides. So you're leaning on your right hand flat on the floor, and your left arm is up now. So slowly leaning on that right hand, lower yourself down. And then if you can get onto your elbow, that's great. And then get the left arm as far back as you can, and then pull the shoulder blade down your back. Breathing, don't hold your breath. And again, before you come up, take the arm in front. And then put both hands behind you with your fingers pointing towards the back. Okay? So your hands are flat on the floor. And then first of all, bend both elbows. Now you're going to keep your elbows bent. And then press the heels of your hands into the floor. Open out your chest and squeeze your shoulder blades together. Okay, and then once you've got in that position, I'm going to take three deep breaths, breathe in, expanding the ribs and the lungs, and breathe out. And again, breathe in, and breathe out. One more time, deep breath in, and breathe out. Okay, push yourself up. Give your arms a little circle. And I want you to put your right hand on your right shoulder and then use your left hand, sit up tall and push that elbow back. So we're just trying to increase the range of movement in the shoulder here and also stretch the tricep. So if you can reach, I want you to hold around the back of the front of the elbow and try and pull it back now. If that's uncomfortable, if your head gets in the way, just keep pushing. Perfect. Roll the shoulders back again. And then do the other side. So you want your left hand on your left shoulder. Use the right hand to gently push that elbow back. Make sure it feels comfortable. Sit up tall. Keep breathing. It's comfortable and you can reach, you can start to pull the elbow from behind now. Sit up tall. And relax and roll back. Okay, so we're going to put both feet on the floor now. Hold around the front of your knees and pull them into your chest, so that you can feel all the muscles in your back squeezing. I'm sorry if you were looking forward to a lie down. Not today. I'm evil Sam today. Okay, relax, and then just push yourself up onto your feet so you're in a squatting position. Keep your hands on the floor and then straighten your legs as much as you can. Okay, I'll just turn sideways. And then we're going to round the back so you're into an angry cat position so that your hands lift away from the floor. Let your head drop. And then do some circles with the arms. gently bend your knees, put your hands on your thighs and slowly uncurl, pushing on your thighs until you're standing up nice and straight. Give your feet a little paddle. And then we're just going to do one balance. I have no idea what time it is. Am I going on? I am, aren't I? Won't be long now. So we're going to, I would come off your mat if I were you and then stand by something just in case you fall over, okay? Have a chair or a wall next to you. So the wider you have your feet, the easier it is. So if you want a bit of a challenge, put your feet together. So we're going to breathe in and then just lift up onto your toes, okay? And then see if you can let go. And then we're going to raise the arms over the head. Stretch as tall as you can. Put your hands together like you're saying a prayer. And then bring them to the front. And then I want you to get them as low as you can so you're feeling a stretch in your wrists. You're still on your tiptoes. Focus. Stretching the wrists. Ooh, you're all very focused. Unless all your screens are frozen, you're looking good. Okay, lower the heels and then just make a fist with your hands and then circle the wrists around and paddle your feet at the same time. And then circling the wrists the other way. I was going to do more balancing, but it's nearly 10 past, so I won't keep you. Okay, and then take your feet wide now. Toes out, cross the arms, bend the knees, circle the arms, take a big deep breath in, stretch and squeeze, and breathe out. Again, breathe in, stretch and squeeze, and breathe out. And one more time, big deep breath in, and breathe out. And that is it, you are done. Well done, guys. Give yourselves a big clap. Okay, if you want to go, just go. I know I've been dragging on a bit. Otherwise, if you want a little chat, turn on your mics. Where's my phone? Turn that off. Just check you're all okay.
Thank you very much, Sam. Very good.
Okay, no problem, Steve. See you soon. Yeah, see you tomorrow.
Thanks, Sam.
Are you all right? Sorry, Steve, what?
Pilates boot camp, that one.
Oh. I haven't moved much this morning, so I think I needed that. Been a bit lazy.
I think I will be able to walk tomorrow, thank you.
You will, I know, you'll be stiff tomorrow.
Yeah.
All right then, as long as you're all okay, yeah? All right, see you tomorrow. Prickly balls tomorrow, yeah. Take care. Bye, everyone.